here we are in Belial's area. I have figured out a way to kill Belial somewhat consistently, and by somewhat, I mean, you still have to be careful, but it's more doable. Okay, so right here, we're approaching him, and the real one's attacking me, so let's just run away and kill off anything else that's nearby, get rid of all that crap. We can't be having normal mobs in here when I'm trying to fight this dude. So, I'm gonna try running to the corner, killing off whatever clones might be around, because... Whoa. Yeah. Also, it would be nice if real Belial would just get the fuck off. So, kill the clones, just to make it more easier for yourself, if they're down there. Then, use your summons. I use Scourges, since they're a lot better than Hoplites, especially in the early and mid games. Then attempt to, attempt to find the real Belial, which he's probably a mouse now, so I'm not gonna find him. The Slayers will still find him, because obviously they're coded to just attack the nearest enemy, no matter what that might be. And recast Slayers. It is obvious which one the real Belial is if they're standing next to each other, because the real Belial will be have a purplish or purple pinkish tint. Right there, yeah. Try to name lock him if you can, but don't try and tank his comet. And the summons you have, unless you have minion summoned life, which you should not do because it'll take away from your spell damage, or at least as a caster. Also, I think I'm targeting a clone. Yeah, I am. Yeah, the real one's the mouse, which... Yeah. I'm gonna throw out Slayer, because they will always target them no matter what. So yeah, you do this over and over again, and if the clones get to be too numerous and too unmanageable, especially if real Belial's away from them, then kill them off. If you can name lock him and tank him, do so, but if you can't, don't even attempt it. Like, if his Bloodstar Phalanx takes like 10 to 20% of your health per hit, then obviously don't be tanking it. You're just gonna get yourself killed. And obviously, with it being a lockout area, you can't go back once you're dead. So you kind of just... Where is he? There he is. Try and name lock him. Until he throws down a comet on my face. Or throws out too many clones. And sometimes he'll seemingly just damage you for no reason. I think it's because his attacks are invisible or something. I don't know what the deal is with that. Or maybe it's just the Phalanx not showing up. Regardless, if you notice your health going down, just run away. Don't try and tank. The clones aren't really that bad, but as most of you know, but don't be trying to tank like 50 of them. Also, I couldn't quite tell where that was headed. I wanted to be safe. Better to be safe than sorry. And I need to use a potion. This is not as easy as it was with the Thorn Warden or Crossbow Necro, for sure. Since Crossbow Necro could kill the clones literally the second that they spawn, and Thorn Warden could just face tank everything. Run away from that. Oh my! Being very... Yeah. You probably could do this with Hoplites if you have enough plus skills and they actually can tank a little bit better because of Rapture. This is assuming you already have 140 or 169 lightning enemy resistance, minus enemy lightning resistance, to hit the 170 and 199 breakpoints respectively. This is also factoring in the fact that Mind Flay itself has Pierce whenever it, or debuffs enemies whenever it hits an enemy. Okay. I think I have a clone name locked somehow. Okay, just run away. Luckily, he can't spawn with extra modifiers, like extra strong or cursed and crap like that. Also, I'm gonna throw up this portal back there just to make sure I don't accidentally go into it. Where is he? Look out! I see a clone. Okay, targeting a clone. There might be one too many clones, so let's clear that out. I'm only showing this because, obviously, I never actually killed Belial yet. I mean, I tried him in the last segment, but died. Get out of there. I think if you have enough health and max cold res, you could tank his comet, but as you can see, I clearly don't. And it's not worth doing anyway. Oh man, yeah, there's way too many clones. I gotta kill off a few clones. I just gotta kill off a clone or two. Unless the real one dies, of course. Then I can just get out of here. Or... okay. Yeah, let's just remove the clones. Get out of here. Ah! And also, this is a really bad predicament I'm in, because real Belial is so close to all of his clones. There's a clone dead. So this all comes down to keeping your summons active, or alive, being able to avoid his attacks and have enough damage to him, to and his clones, of course, to be able to really do a number on him. The clones don't hurt nearly as much, but you're not going to be able to tell the difference between clone attacks and real Belial attacks just by looking. And also, you should probably stay out of his melee range if you're a caster, because he can hurt a lot in melee range. I hear he can potentially one-shot, though I've never seen that happen myself. Oh, yikes, real Belial's up there. Get out of there! I know. So far, I've actually been getting better luck with his attacks not being invisible than normal, but... Look out. And he is dead. Yourself, Belial. Oh my, get out of there. And so we're done. And that was a really shit roll, but I have already farmed off screen for a better one. So, on that note, let's move on to something more fun, shall we? Let me equip my dream flange that I found during the Signet farming stream. We're doing the Dimensional Labyrinth now. So I've not tried this. Luckily I have enough pierce to essentially one-shot stuff. If I want to farm this properly, I need to farm Cabraxis for a +3 max fire resistance and cold resistance, which would be a 1 in 9 chance of dropping. And I can already move on to level 2, but let's clear out. Nice, 2 in a row. I can already go on the level 2, but we're gonna stay in level 1 for a bit. Fuck you. Fuck you, you stun-locking piece of shit. Thank God the lower levels don't have lockout anymore. But yeah, that's why... Fuck you, Aranus, you piece of shit. Get the hell out of here. Now, I'm not gonna do the whole thing right now, because obviously I'm underprepared for it. I don't have enough health, I'm not using Rapture, and I don't have -199 Pierce. Well, I could get a Crown Shield, I suppose. Man, 3 level 2 Rift Stones, holy moly. Also, I'm killing everything for some experience, because even though this area is a little bit low-leveled for this, this area is actually really good for experience. See, look at that. 20 per enemy. That's about on par with Duncraig. And Duncraig's level 125, so, yeah. And another Rift Stone. How many have I found? 1, 2, 3... 4 already. Whoa, do not save exit. I accidentally did that during an Astroga run. Just run away. Sinew Shaper dead. If somehow I'm able to get this build to a point where I can actually do the lower level Dimensional Labyrinth stuff, I may try and get to level 15 and do the boss at the end of the area. Though my chances of doing it are pretty much zero, even fully optimized with endgame gear and such. Okay, I gotta keep summons active just for meat shields and nothing else. Oh, I'm debuffed with Mithil. Oh, I need way more flat resistance, because look at this. Yeah, that's unacceptably low. was gonna say, can I kill the observer, please? Thank you. Alright, so one death here. Although that was mostly because of stun locking. Onwards to level 2. I'm gonna go back to town for this. Now keep in mind, I don't have Dream Flange MO'd with anything. I forget what the stats were, other than, like, they do more damage. Having reanimates is nice, although I know in later levels, I want to say in level 6 or 7, enemy corpses will no longer have can no longer reanimate into anything. I forget what level it is, but I do know that enemy corpses will no longer help you, or can no longer help you in any way. And also, with completing Belial, I've now done every 125 Uber in the game, except for Giowa, because fuck Giowa, it's an obnoxious piece of shit for an obnoxious bullshit charm upgrade, that being the Umbaru treasure, which I must bitch about constantly, and Witch, but I can't do Witch right now, because, yeah, 8,000 health, yeah. I'm probably going to respect to Unholy Melee and have Grim Presence active for that fight. Yikes. Okay, I can't be doing that. I fail to see any other reason. I fail to see any other build I could respect into. My god, that was close. Fuck! Get through there, summons. Alright, I'm just throwing out Slayers. If I even can. Okay, I can. Have them attack. I still love that Mind Flay can kill through walls. And luckily, these attacks don't pierce. Unlike the Necrobots do. And I'm almost level 130. Hey. Ernest, get out of here. Aranice, get out of here. Oh my. The Colossal Tunnelers. They hurt quite a bit. Oh, I'm gonna die here. I just know I will. Gargoyle Trap, get the hell out of here. Yeah. Okay, there's a necromancer somewhere. Here he is. What does he drop? Drops body armor and jewelry. Or just armor and jewelry. Diadem, jewel, plated belt. Serpent's Tongue, that could be gotten rid of because nobody uses Nagisin. At least as far as I know, no one uses Nagisin still. Everyone I know that plays Sin either throws Sin or traps Sin. Occasionally Shuriken, but Mostly throw and trap. So I can't quite... I'm not exactly able to face tank like I could with the Thorn Warden, but that's fine. I'll probably do better against assassins, though. Aranis die. Get out of here. Now, someone can correct me if I'm wrong, but isn't there a point in the labyrinth where I can't use teleport to gather my summons? I'm pretty sure that that's a thing that ends up happening. I mean, that'll probably happen, like, really late. And by late, I mean to a point that I'll never get to at this rate. Yeah, because that will happen. And the later levels do still have lockout. Yeah, this will definitely require practice on my part before I can actually do this properly. And better gear, of course. Better gear, more firelight, or... better gear and more cold and fire resistance, both flat and max. And raw rune, which I don't care about. Let's try and kill these through the wall, which luckily I can do. Or from around the corner with Slayer, which, there we go. I think eventually I should just preemptively do that. Just to ensure that I survive later. So summon more Scourge. Get Vindicate. I should probably not be trying to face tank this. Alright, is that it? I think that might be it. Alright, moving on to level 3. And I'm always in the mode of getting better MOs. Or, not MOs, jewels. Especially whenever I get to a point where I don't need any more Pierce, and Hoplites even would be okay. Where's level 3? There's level 3. Okay, this is still Act 5 Cave. I think now these guys do 50% more damage than the level 1 counterparts do. Or no, I think it's 20, actually. I don't think it goes up that high. But I know it does go up pretty high. Pretty fast. Almost level 130. Alright, level 130. And we're just gonna... Ah! Get these remate flesh out of here. Hey, get... kill them off, then. Come on, Scourges. One more point in TB. His Tainted Blood always needs to be maxed. Ah! Later on, this is gonna one-shot me at this rate, and I know it will. Gauntlets. I know I pronounced it wrong. I did that on purpose. Gauntlets. Can you hit the... can you hit the... thank you. At least those things don't actually hit me very often. Okay, if that barrage had hit me, I'd be dead. Undoubtedly. Zap, zap, zap. Get those reanimates on the field. I love this thing. Although, as I said, I will still trade it for a good ornate crafted paladin helmet or blessed wrath. Oh my god! Yep. I knew that was gonna happen at some point. Oh, I gotta improve and get better at this. Yeah. Where'd I die? I think it was over here. Yeah, it was over here. It was like right before I would have finished clearing it too. Oh well. Have I found a level 4? No, I haven't. So, I just got really unlucky here. Oh well. It's not a big deal. I think I cleared the whole area. Let me make sure. Oh, no, there's still some more enemies left. Go, 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 go. I know I was over... oh my god, no! I was not over there yet. Whoops. Okay. Yeah, I'm just getting sloppy here. Holy moly. Ah, and another corrupted necromancer. Let's... no, I don't want to move. I want to shift hold over this way, please. Do the necromancer summons give reanimates when killed? I somehow doubt it, because I think that would be little bit broken in the lower levels. And he's dead. Mystic die, do not care about that. Oh! Get those summons on the field. Go! There's level 4 Riftstone, but I'm not doing that. Because, you know what you can do at level 130 now, right? Well, actually, you can do a few things at 130. But we're doing this. We're not doing the full fight. I'm just telling you that right now, because, like Witch, I want a lot more HP before I attempt this fight. Or before I attempt the final fight, rather. Let's just run through all this. I did get a plus 10 all attribute here, so I don't need to kill anything. Well, I mean, other than what's directly in my road here. Dead. Also, I gotta love also when light wells just spawn either on top of or next to the totem, or to the portals. Go, and at this point I should just probably give everything. No, don't run towards him, just kill off everything. Hunt, attack Anarius, there we go. I am going to want to farm at least 2 trophies, one for the idol itself, and one for Witch Charm, because I want the bonus energy factor. So since I'm not doing physical damage, I imagine the dark spawn. I imagine the dark spawn summons won't be that hard to deal with. So let's see. We all know how this goes. You kill Sloth until he drops the thing. Also, I'm not sure if this bugged him out. It did not. Okay, so you can just teleport up here. And you can also be safe for the dark spawns for a little bit. And I see he actually drops some gold this time around. It's probably fat. It's actually... Oh! Oh, that went well. Ooh, boy, that went well. So, let's see. Moving on to Gluttony. If the Scourges can tank him long enough with Slayers, I could probably just give him with Mind Flay. I'm guessing. No, don't kill him there! He'll drop his... no pun intended here. He'll drop his reward into the void. What the fuck? Hello? Gluttony? What? Is he immune to Mind Flay? No? There we go! What the hell? Why wasn't he getting hurt with Mind Flay? I don't get it. But, Greed? If Slayers can do enough damage, I'm thinking Slayers alone can kill him off. Provided I can get to him and teleport. Oh, shit. Actually, that's probably not a... Okay, yeah, that's actually not a good idea. Oh, and I still have Dream Flange equipped. Which technically does lower damage, but... Again, keep in mind, I've not MO'd that with more... with more lightning spell damage, like I did with Void Stream. Okay, so... And I'm just gonna get gibbed as soon as he hits me again. At least I can kill the dark spawns quick. Yeah, I forget how far away those slayers can attack from. And I can just yip anything that comes out of here. Or, okay. Okay, I think I summoned three. I know it made the sound four times, but I think I only summoned three of them. Okay, I think I summoned four there. Yeah, this is an easy greed, holy shit. I mean, even though I did die to him once, but... Is that... Okay, cool. And greed is my bitch. Lust might be a little bit difficult because... Because I at least I have DR. Come on. Lust, where are you? Lust. Yeah. Although Lust does not heal, so thank God. So I could probably just do what I need to do to kill her. Oh, and let's kill off all these before I get decimated. No. Okay. Yeah, I had a feeling this one would be a little bit obnoxious, but no big deal. Enforce summon says, "Oh, you suck. I could do everything in here deathlessly." Oh, blah, 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 blah. Fuck you too. I don't care. Kill off the dark spawns. For the record, you get no experience from it, but holy shit, dark spawns. Yeah, I gotta finish off Lust and stop talking to Decker Kane. Nobody cares what he thinks. Come on, fuck. Can we get rid of Lust? Come on, let's get rid of Lust. If I have to, I'll kill myself just to get, like, just to get these guys away. Yeah, what? Yeah, let's just die on purpose here. Of course, that time I lived a little bit when I'm trying to die, but not when I'm trying to actually kill her. Come on, Lust. Okay, I hit her by accident. Can we pick up the scroll? Please? Let me pick up this... Thank you. I guess we can herd everybody over here and then die again. Not having Rapture is kind of bad here. Actually, you know what? Screw it. We'll just run away and teleport. Whoop! Plane of Wrath. Now, Wrath would be really hard if I didn't have... Wrath might be hard if I didn't have, the Ashari sets. Except, oh wait, I have the Ashari sets, so, let's kill off all these assholes. I'm not even calling them ass trolls, I'm just calling them assholes, period. Also, Darkspawn, get out of here. Get out of here. Okay. The Ashari set time. I definitely need to get rid of that.
I can't.
Oh, whoops. No.
I can't.
I don't know why I keep trying to put stuff in there. And where's the armor? Oh. Okay. Full set. 9,000 health. I now have 90 all resistant. 90% all res. Wrath, you are nothing. Also, I don't know if this is a bug or intended, but, normally it would say immune to all damage at the bottom, but here it's displaying all the the individual resistances. They reduced his damage by 15%, but once again, just use the Ashari set. Like, any build can use it. Drink a potion when necessary, and just kill him off. And dead. Now I can get rid of the set entire. Now I can get rid of the Ashari sets completely. Because I will not farm Yashari Sanctum for that trophy. No, I will absolutely not farm the trophy. Actually, no, I'm going to signet that.
Impossible.
And I'll put this away for right now, since I'm not going to need it for a bit.
I can't.
Okay, where's the thing? And I'm still not even at 400 signets yet. I'm still at 325, which I just hit. Okay, kill off these dudes. Many there are. Thankfully, I actually have 3-second teleport, unlike with any other build. Or any other character class, I should say, minus the assassin. Fuck off, asshole! Anyway. Envy. The Slaves of Envy might be bad if I can't kill them off quick, but if I can, then Envy should actually be somewhat easy. I mean, the thing is not immune to magic, so unlike in the past, I actually can use Slayer to help kill it. And the thing no longer uses its 1 HP Nova, and the slaves no longer one-shot you with their bullshit attack. So, yeah, Envy, okay, the slaves are just dying like nothing. Oh, and I'm stun locking them too, I think. Get some reanimates, they're not gonna help me, but whatever. I mean, they might a little bit, but. So only thing I gotta watch for here, if Mind Flay kills as fast as I think it might, yeah, it's totally going to, is to not kill him over a pit. I cannot kill him over a pit like Gluttony. Oh, he casts a Bone Nova. No. No. Die right there, yep. Well, that was a much easier Gluttony than it was with the Thorn Warden, I can tell you that much. Man, I must have been burning through potions. Okay. And last one is Pride. Pride is more potent now, but who the fuck cares? Oh my god, but the lightning dudes are more damaging. Oh, there's a well there. Shit! I was supposed to teleport over here. Whoops. Okay, well, let me die here. I still don't know the fast path through here. And of course, there's crap there. Get, go, 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 go. Mmm! Okay, this is actually going to be obnoxious then. Maybe I want Dream Flange for this, I'm not sure. Get. That's probably a really shitty idea. Yeah, yeah. Summons aren't gonna help there, because those attacks pierce. Yeah, I think I might be fucked. I think I just might be fucked here. I'll whip out Dream Flange again and see if that helps with this. Teleport back. Oh, there's like 50 of them up there. Oh, this is fucking hilarious. Yep. Okay, fuck you, Pride. Alright, that's that. I'll attach me doing Pride after this, so I'll see you guys momentarily, I guess. Alright, let's see. What's the path again? And I looked at Pride. Also, I forgot to fucking equip my Dream Flange. This is not the right way. I can tell you that with absolute certainty. What the? Now they're not doing any damage? What the fuck? Okay, so apparently I just got unlucky? Oh, shit. Well, I got unlucky here, too. Because there's a, oh, God. Okay, the tip of green flame strike hit me, which, even if it had not been buffed, it still would have killed me. Yikes, okay, let's summon shit then. Okay, apparently Pride's damage buff does matter. Still, it's worth it to get rid of Envy being a fucking shit stain. And there we go. Ring of Pride. Now, yikes. Greed, Lust, Envy, Wrath, Gluttony, Sloth, Pride, boom. And I got a really shitty roll, but like that matters. So that's Void, and once I get more Signets, or once I finish my Signet farming, and Signet farming and get some more Belladonnas together, I will do Witch, do the Void fight, and possibly Lazarus in that spec. I don't know if I can. But off screen, I'm going to look at Lazarus to see if I actually could, if I actually need the Rathmus Supremacy to do him. I mean, I'm going to want it anyway, but I'll just check off screen to see if I can actually do it. So, anyway, I will see you guys next time.